up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging up both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. They're free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. Tonight, it's the Sunday night opener for the new NFL season, as it'll be the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on their in-state rivals to the south, the Miami Dolphins. It's the marquee game of opening weekend, and off we go on a Sunday night on EA Sports. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
Stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Now second and nine. Justin Herbert looking to pass. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. 23 yards the pick up there.
Well, partner, that's the start that you want right there. And you know he spent the entire offseason throwing hundreds, I'd probably say thousands of passes, getting ready for that moment. The first throw of the new season. He's dreamed about it, thought about it, and now it's out of the way.
Now, one for one, a lot more to go. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, here's Herbert. This is caught inside the 15. Are on the board here first in the season opener. That's all good with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10 at their own 15. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
They run for the first time with Javonte Williams. The result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Again, it's Williams. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Give it to Williams, running right. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert when they turn it over. Now Achane on first and 10. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Well, that's a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play.
Nowhere to go for Herbert, and he's going to go down. Third and 12. Back to throw here, Herbert. Under pressure, and they got to him again.
Multiple defenders getting home there for a loss of 11.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half. And if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere, they've got to find a way to keep him upright so he can throw the football.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. On the return, here's Agnew. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so, but maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
The Jags with a football to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a second and 13 forthcoming.
Snuffed down.
Well, times have definitely changed on the PAT, on the extra point, haven't they? A lot more effort goes into this play from both sides.
Yeah, because let's face it, a lot of time on extra points, the effort is not what it is when you're trying to block a field goal.
No doubt about it. Before, when the ball was snapped on the 2-yard line, there's really a virtual chip shot. Now everyone believes they can get to it and knock it away, and we know how crucial every point is. So the defensive guys, they're spending a lot more time trying to get that done, which means there's more pressure on the offensive guys trying to kick it.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw taken in by Sutton.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And he is going to lose yardage here. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now 3rd and 3.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
They'll come up now 3rd and 3. In motion right goes Sutton. On 3rd down, here's Williams. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. They end up getting stuffed twice after that 9-yard gain back on 1st down.
This defense is really fooling around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
They're going on 4th down. Lawrence. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line. A great pick, nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind. Going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough.
And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Derrick Henry. A touchdown run there from a yard out. And the Dolphins are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point put through by Boswell. And that pushes the lead up to an even 20. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. They stick to the ground game on 1st down. It's Williams. He'll get this to about the 38. 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Lawrence, and he will find Ridley on the left side, and he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. That one, a 1st down pickup of 8. Now a 1st down carry, it's Williams, and he's across midfield and into Miami territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down.
Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 7 yards there and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw, Lawrence. Looking for Ridley on the out route. He's got him. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Here's second and 5 now from the 37. Up the middle, it's Williams. And a very determined run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 27. Good effort. Lawrence going to move him around a bit. They'll stay on the ground with Williams. And he'll be taken down just shy of the red zone at the 21. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Here, and I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved. They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and 8. Following the penalty, it's Williams, and he'll get it down this time to the 17. The first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10.
A gain of 9 yards. First down, Jacksonville.
11, 11. Here we go. The busy night continues for Williams. And they'll get him down right around the 16. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry.
Now they'll audible to something else.
And now they'll throw it with Lawrence. And he's going to drop this off to Williams. Complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it brings up 3rd and 5 now. Has already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Pick it up. You're embarrassing
it. A chance for their first points of the season here as it's 1st and goal.
30 left.
They'll try and run. This is Williams. His way into the end zone for a touchdown.
Javonte Williams,
a 5-yard touchdown run.
And the Jaguars get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
Extra point from McManus is good. And that cuts this lead down to 13.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
And with a 2-score lead already, they may just look to get this thing to the locker room.
They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Second and six.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. Shifts by him at the 25. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three.
Easy.
Here's Lawrence. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They're trying to run for it. Here's Williams. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Rob has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now carry number 20 of the game. Here's Williams. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43.
86 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. Now Lawrence changing the play.
On second down, Williams.
And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43.
A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for first and 10.
Lawrence will throw.
And he'll find Sutton on the right side complete. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
From the 35, here's second and a couple. Now they'll change things around before the snap.
They'll run out of the gun here. Williams. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left
defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And he will have a Jaguars first down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2.
A give to Williams, running right.
And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line.
10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20.
Again, it's Williams. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Now Lawrence to throw on 2nd down.
Will go down as a gain of 6. And this will wind up being a 3rd and 3.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. In motion right is Ridley.
They give it to Williams, running right. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Williams. Fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard, that's all, down to the 2.
Only a yard that time, 2nd and goal.
All of a sudden, those lanes that were there earlier in the drive dry up near the goal line. That's a good job defensively to diagnose the run and stop it for a very short pickup.
Williams is not going anywhere. He'll be hit and dropped for no gain at the 2-yard line.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
Sometimes I get caught hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, 2nd half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
Meanwhile, on 3rd down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Still just the 3rd quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th.
Here's Lawrence to throw.
Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Cortland Sutton, a 2-yard touchdown grab.
And the Jaguars are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the 3rd.
McManus's point after is good. And the lead will shrink to 6.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a 1-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a 1-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change. Because otherwise, that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
1 quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL.
on EA Sports. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football. It's also Dolphin lead to begin quarter number four. Here's second and 10. They'll run it again with Henry. Able to push his way through. And still fighting. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The Miami first down on a 14-yard pickup. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage. Work on that clock. See if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football. Gain some yardage and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Here's Herbert. Escaping the pressure right. And off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
On third down, Achane. Sprung in that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 4 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario.
Oh, no, he lost the football. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Off the option, here's Henry. And they're knocking on the door now. There's a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line. They'll try to run for it with Henry. And he will tuck it in. Great Dolphins touchdown. Derrick Henry. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Dolphins are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the first and goal, and then one play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is, I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard charging run, give it right back to him, and let him cap things off.
And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. And of course, on the 2-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? Open receiver, ball's put on him. 2 points for that.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance of victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly is on the defensive side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly. And what a benefit for them, able to pick that one off and hopefully put this game away.
On second down, a run by Achane. And a short gain down to about the 33. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down. The Dolphins on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Boswell's kick is good, and the Dolphins will add on to their lead.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you.
And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
Call it a gain of six on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Hey, Lion, Lion!
Now Lawrence to throw. He'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks him. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
They had to put it mildly. But look at the lead. Look at the deficit. Trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all. And you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
Tremaine Edmonds there to bring him down. Here's a second and 8. Again, it's Henry. And they get him behind the line, so that short gain on first down quickly negated. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
Two things to watch. First is strength and being able to break out of that initial contact. But at his size, once you slow his momentum, it's hard for him to get it started again and end up tackling him behind the line of scrimmage.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 53 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Second and 11. Running from the gun with Henry. Fighting through, and he's got space. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Well, partner, that'll do it. These week one primetime games, they always seem to have a little bit more electricity, a little more anticipation, a fun one tonight, and a lot of fun ones that we have on the road ahead.
And, partner, I love the word you just used there, electricity. Things were crackling out there.
to a demon when he off them. Ride till I die. I hope that Jesus come and grind a wheel. That singing like Clay Aiken. R.I.P. to all my loved ones that ain't make it. Got a bond with the streets and I just can't break it. Run it up. Now my safe done turn into my safe haven. Them racks saying okay, okay. On the block, I'm post up, I can't fade away. Baby, I've been too turned, I don't care about what a hater say. Dark skin, thick, thick. I like the soul, I named the bay. I'm in it every day. New drip, I just spent some G's on my attire. These ratchets keep on going, but my jeans getting tighter. I went overseas with the swiper. Bad, bad, no, I never seen nothing like her.